nobody help when I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I ball. Man, like every day. For all of that, nobody helped me. Said I ball on you. Man, like every day. For all the times you dated me. Man, I ball. Man, like every day. Until the day I pass away, I say I ball.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Straight ahead, it's Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a great one in store between the Seattle Seahawks and the Houston Oilers. What twists and turns will January have in store for us? The NFL playoffs are officially underway. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Across the 30-yard line. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down.
So a nice run there, and I have to think a strong running game in the playoffs, maybe even more critical than the regular season. And if you go by the numbers, the man they have running it here, he was the best in the NFL.
And since he led the league in rushing yards, I think it means he's going to see the ball a lot in this game, too, because that's what they're built like. That's what they're built around. So I think the offensive line, the tight end, the wide receivers, everyone is coming together wanting him to get the ball and get it often, and they want to carve some holes out there for him.
And they'll run on the inside handoff.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Hands it off out of the gun. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Switch it up here and look to throw. Rolling to, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Christian Wilkins in there to drop him for a loss on the play. It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. He'll look to throw. Going left side here, and it's complete. And he'll be stopped right at midfield.
Patriots. Opening drive, third down. They go with a slant. It works.
And I'm wondering when the league's going to figure it out, because everyone throws it on third down. You expect pressure, so you want the ball out of the hands of the quarterback quickly. It's a three-step route ordinarily, and you're throwing it where you see the receiver breaking towards you. So it's an inside route. Everyone likes it, and it's executed very well.
There's a run on first down that doesn't accomplish anything. In fact, he's going to be tackled behind the line for a loss of one.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. Now they try the right side here. Room to run inside the 40. And now off to the races. Down the right side. Touchdown, Houston. A big play there. 51 yards. And the Oilers will strike first here in this wild card matchup. The point after is good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded right at the goal line. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at the 20. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Well, the first play of the drive lost 4. Now they'll look to move it forward here on 2nd and 14. And not a whole lot to speak of there, as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. 3 yards is the pickup, but it leaves them still needing 11 here on third down. They go play action now. Wilson. And the catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. But this seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot, and they responded pretty well there. You go 3 and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down 2 scores, could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot of the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And this will be a Seahawks first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
Good running right there. And this is a man who was a 1,000-yard rusher in the regular season, so you know he's going to get his chances. And he picks up nice yardage on that one.
So after 2 first downs, they get another here. 1st and 10 at the 45. And he'll give it here to his running back. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
And they didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
Now a pass dumped off to his running back. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. Here's Wilson. That's going to be caught by Moss. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Now a handoff here to his running back. It was Josh Sweat who got him down on the defensive side.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
They go play action with Wilson. On the move to his left, and his throw is incomplete.
And the end result of that play, you're almost not sure what you really want, because when he gets outside of the pocket, you actually hold your breath because you think he's going to run for big yardage. But when he chose to pull it down and throw it, and a play was made to knock it away, that's a pretty good end result. Not one you expected when the play began.
Yeah, he's got it. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds.
A very important third down conversion right there, because when you're trailing and find yourself this deep in enemy territory, the kicker's not even part of your thought process. You got to make it pay off with six. Nice connection right there to set up first and goal.
Wilson. Touchdown, Seahawks. A 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up. Jason Myers now for the extra point. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
Now this time he'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly, and knocked it free.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 34.
Well, this is simply a great read by a defensive back. It's third and 10, so he sits right on where the yard to gain marker is, knows it's going to be a route around that distance, makes his read, breaks on the football, and makes a terrific play.
Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. And that'll get him halfway there as he takes it from the 6 to the 3-yard line.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
Seahawks have taken the lead. Myers connects on the PAT, and that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up 2 straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up.
And he'll work this forward for about 3 at 2nd down. The last run got 3, now here's 2nd and 7. He'll look to throw. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown, Houston. Dallas Goedert, 52 yards. And the Oilers are an extra point away from drawing level. Now they'll line up to kick the extra point. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. This one.